I'm Alan. This video is part two, and in this video we finish machining the steel body and continue making the probe insulation block and end cap components for the electric edge finder. At the end of the video I've included some sketches of all the four parts so you can make your own. The probe is designed around a 14mm body and an 8mm diameter battery holder. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. So at the moment I've got a 10mm hole in here that goes down to an 8mm on the other end. It's been faced and there's a centre, a chamfer on the end, a 60 degree chamfer that will accept a centre. The other end of the bar, we've put an 8mm hole, then we've machined it out and tapped a 10mm hole, and there is a chamfer on this end, 60 degree, that will accept a centre. So it's important for this that the outside is running true to the holes. So I'm going to hold this between centres and then machine the outside down to just under 14mm, put the revolving centre in the tailstock. On the headstock I've put this drive plate with the drive bar centre in this end. This centre you don't need to lubricate because it moves with the head, so it's not actually rubbing on the steel. And this centre is a revolving centre with bearings, so that's not rubbing on the steel. So I don't need to put any lubrication on the centres. I'll take that out so you can see. This is just a driving dog, which is clamped on. So what I want to do is machine most of this down to 14mm and then turn it round and then just blend the other side into it. So I'll go about halfway. So that's 0.621. And by the way, if you're not sure which way the carrier goes, the machine side always goes to the bar that's pushing it, because that's machined central to the bore. Just put the chamfer on this end. Just give it a polish. I'll put this back in the chuck. All I need to do is drill a hole through the side. This is the side with the 10mm hole in. And what this is a couple of bearings. Linear bearings, so that can slide in and out, and inside this bar a bearing each end with a chuck on the end, so I can rotate the chuck using a electric drill. That fits in my tool post. Okay, I've just touched the edge of the drill on there, so now I'll move it in. It's 17mm plus half the diameter. Lock up my slide, just double check, it's about 17mm in. small dimple on the end. And I need to open it up one side to up to 6 millimeters. This is a LED which should just fit in there. Turn this round. And I've just taken the sharp edge off that. There's the two, well, three parts we made in brass. Now this is the body. We've got a hole in the side, 3 mil that side, 5 mil that side, 10 mil hole there, that a threaded 10 mil with an 8 mil bore down the middle. And the next thing we need to make is the plastic sleeve that goes inside. This is a hard plastic. I don't know what the type of plastic is. It was something I found. So my collet's a half inch collet, and this is 0.558. Okay, that's the plastic. That fits on my collet, so I'll change my chuck now for my collet. Put that in my ER20 collet, 12 millimeter. What we're making is the inside of this tube. That's going to fit in there to hold the LED and insulate the electrical connections from the outside. Okay, I've turned the part round in the collet and I'm on the other end. I just want to face that to get it square. Now, because I want a flat bottom to this hole, I'm using a 5 millimeter end mill to give me the 5 millimeter hole with a flat bottom. And because I've got my collet on the lathe with the drawbar through and a nut on the end, I can use a spanner on the nut just to turn round the headstock. And I've got my guide in the end to guide the tap in. I've changed my tap for the bottoming tap. Just supporting the end with the centre to stop it flexing. The length needs to be 47 millimeters. This is 60. I've machined the length of 47 millimeters and now I've set up the tool post spindle to do a cross drill. okay that side. This is the LED. And that's drilled halfway through, so the LED will fit in halfway. So there's the finished item. Thread in this end to hold the probe. Hole through, and we've got a 4mm hole straight through. What I want to do is reduce this diameter, centre drill of face, centre drill to suit a ball bearing. Now the ball bearing that you use on this is the actual probe part. This is the ball bearing I'm using. It's a 3/8 ball bearing. You can use metric bearings, depends. It doesn't make any difference. Use the centre drill to form a cone in the end, so that bearing will sit in the end. And what you need is the bearing to be bigger than the shaft that you're using. So when it touches the edge of the part, it's the bearing that touches and not the shaft. You see that bearing sits in there. So when I solder that bearing onto the end, it'll have plenty of grip, so that'll be okay. Now it's important that this centre, and when I make the thread on this end, they're all true. Okay, I put my collets back on, 20 collet, holding the outside that I've just turned. Looks as if it's running out quite a bit. So I've got a centre drill for the ball in this end and a small one in this end. So I'll put the centres in now, turn this down between centres so I know that that diameter is running true, turn it round, turn this down between centres so I know that this diameter is running true, and put the thread on the end. I changed my lathe tool so I can get in closer to the edge, and I'm going to turn the diameter down to 6mm. Now that should be around 6mm. Point 2, 36. 236. I'm looking for 236, so that's smack on 6mm. I've had to change the carrier to a homemade carrier because the width of this carrier is too wide for that small length on the diameter. This should just fit in same. You can see how close the centre drill is to the edge. So all this is running true between centres. Okay, now I've put my collet holder back on. I've put a die in my die stock, number M6. Now right up to the face. Now I'll turn the die round so I can come right up to this face with a thread. Now that's touching the face. So by turning the die round, you've cut a thread right up to the face. I set up the indexing fixture in the mill vise. I've got a 12mm end mill. And what I want to do is come down just to touch the face to get my position. So that's just touching the part where I want to put the flats on. Rotate it round 180 degrees. Here's the finished probe, and I must admit that I have made two of these, one with a larger diameter than the other, so I can have a different size ball. This is the last part to make, the end cap. The end cap is just a 10mm thread by 10mm long on a 13mm diameter that's been knurled with a dome on the end, so it's nothing complicated. That's the seven components completed, so next time we'll show the assembly and test it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.